Changing ways, so-called liberated days. A story comes to mind of a friend of mine. Georgia boy was gay, I guess. Nothing more or nothing less. The kindest guy I ever knew. His mother's tears fell in vain. The afternoon George tried to explain that he needed love like all the rest. Paul said there must be a mistake. How can my son not be straight after all I've said and done for him? Leaving home on a Greyhound bus, cast out by the ones he loves, a victim of these gay days, it seems. Georgie went to New York town, where he quickly settled down and soon became the toast of the great white way. Accepted by Manhattan's elite in all the places that were chic, no party was complete without George. Along the boulevards he cruised, and all the old queens blew a fuse. Everybody loved Georgie boy. I saw George alive was in the summer of 75. He said he was in love. I said, I'm pleased. George attended the opening night of another Broadway hype, but split before the final curtain fell. Deciding to take a shortcut home, arm in arm, they meant no wrong. A gentle breeze blew down Fifth Avenue.